What's up, everyone? Coach Blaine from Constancy Fitness here, bringing you another edition of Constancy at Home. Today, I got Christine and Lexi with me. They're gonna help me bring you guys through this little at-home class, warm-up and workout. So, if you guys are ready, we're gonna get started for today. I'm gonna break down the different movements of the warm-up. You're gonna have four different movements. We're gonna move for 20 seconds, rest for 10, and we're gonna go through that two times. So, the first movement is a plank. Couple different ways you can do your plank. You can do them on your hands. Make sure you stay nice and active. You can also drop down to your forearms. A few things we're looking for. Nice flat back, so squeeze your butt. That's gonna prevent any butt raises. But then we also wanna make sure we're not sagging down here. So you can still squeeze your butt and go down here, but you have to squeeze your butt, squeeze your belly to stay nice and flat. So we'll do that for 20 seconds, rest for 10, going into a quarter squat hold. So what that's gonna look like from a side view, you're gonna stick your butt back, keep the chest nice and tall, and you're just gonna pause here, keeping everything nice and tight. Our butt's back, our knees are driven out, and they're behind our toes. Chest is tall, we're just gonna hold that for 20 seconds. Rotate to the next movement, which is glute bridges. So flat on your back, heels drilled into the floor. And what you're gonna do is you're just gonna squeeze your butt to come up. I don't want you super extending up on top of your shoulders, getting into that lower back. We want all the squeezing done right here in your butt. So squeeze up, lower slow. Help turn those glutes on for the workout. And then we're gonna finish with what we call a quad walk in class. Usually we walk with this, but since you're in your house, we're just gonna do these in place. If you're doing this outside or in a garage or somewhere that you have area to move, go ahead and walk with these. What it's gonna look like, you're gonna grab one leg and you're going to bend down as far as you can. The goal is to touch the floor and then you'll switch and touch. So if you're in somewhere where you can walk, this is kind of what it would look like. You would down, take a couple of steps, down. Don't rush it. Work on that balance. You're gonna get a good stretch in your quad and your opposite hamstring. So if you're ready, we're gonna go ahead and get started with the warm-up. Go grab your kids, grab your family, get them down, come do this with you. They need to move too. It's important for not just your health, but their health as well. So pause it, go get them. And pause it and got them, welcome back. 10 seconds. First thing is a plank. There you go. Remember, you can do it from your hands, or you can drop down to your forearms. Quarter squat hold. Quad walk. Or you can go half and half. If you're going half and half, switch now. Make sure that back's flat. We're not sagging and our butt's not high. Quarter squat. Lift your toes up and keep your heels planted. Drive through your heels. You should feel a little more in your hamstrings as well as your glutes. And quad walk. Hope you guys are nice and warm. If you feel like you need a little bit more warm up, go ahead and rewind it and run through that again. But otherwise, we're gonna get started with the workout. So the workout for today is 30 seconds of movement, 30 seconds of rest for four rounds. I'm gonna break down each movement for you here in a second, but they're gonna be alternating V-ups, split squat on the left side, heel touches, and split squat on the right. So we'll go over each movement, give you some different modifications and scaling options for each one of those. So alternating V-up. What that's going to look like, you're going to lay flat on the floor, arms above your head. You're going to bring your shoulders up off the floor and your one leg up and go opposite arm to opposite leg and back down. And you'll go up to the other side. If you're having a hard time getting your leg all the way straight or getting your shoulders all the way up to meet your leg, one scaling option could be a bent leg coming up to touch your toes. So not super bent, but a little bit. Then the next option would be to bring your knee to your chest and still come forward. So you're flat here, and then you're just bringing one knee up to your chest, kind of like a tuck. If you're only able to come up this far, that's fine. Give me everything you got, whatever range of motion you have. Just keep moving for the full 30 seconds. Do what you can, and over time, you're just gonna keep getting better and stronger at these different movements. So that's the alternating V-ups. Next one, we're gonna do split squats on the left. So left leg's gonna be forward. I'm gonna show you a couple views. I'm gonna go forward, I'm gonna turn it to the side, and I'm gonna also show you a harder option. So if you wanted to scale up. So it's gonna be similar to a lunge. So you're gonna lunge out. Notice how I step kind of out into the side. I'm not straight in line, because stability and balance is not the best there. We wanna have a nice strong base. We're on the ball of our foot in the back. You're gonna bring your hips straight down to the floor. We're not gonna hinge forward and bring the knee out over our toes. It's just where your body is, straight down. So just like a squat, just like a lunge, this front knee is driving out, staying behind the front toes. This back knee is just gonna lightly kiss the floor, and you're gonna stand up, lower down. So from the side, what that's gonna look like, down and up. Nice and controlled. If you need a little extra flair to that and want to make it a little more challenging, what you can do is put your foot up on the couch or on a coffee table, a chair, whatever, and we can elevate that back foot and do a Bulgarian split squat. So what that would look like, you're here, dropping straight down and stand up, don't fall over. If you're shorter, your back knee's not gonna get very close to the floor. That's okay. Go as low as you can and stand up with it. If you're a little bit taller and your surface is lower, you might be able to get your knee all the way to the floor. So that's the split squat. If you're having trouble doing that, what I'd recommend is doing a regular lunge. So just step forward and back. But again, if that bothers you, what we can do, we can go to the glute bridges like we did in the warm-up. But what I want you to do, since we're isolating one leg every time we do the split squat, I want you to do the same with your glute bridge. So for split squat left, you're gonna do a glute bridge left leg only. So this right leg, knees are gonna be in line with each other and straight. You're just gonna squeeze that left butt cheek to come up, lower nice and slow. So if you have any issues with your knee, your hip, or anything that's preventing you from doing those split squats, that glute bridge is gonna be a great option for you. Next, we have heel touches. So another little piece of core. You're gonna get into a similar position as your glute bridge. Heels planted, arms down to your side. You're gonna sit up so your shoulders are off the floor, and you're going to rock back and forth, touching your heels. To make it more challenging, you bring your feet together. That increases your range of motion that you have to reach to touch. Also, if you bring your feet further away from you, the more you're gonna have to sit up and reach and touch. To make it a little less challenging, you bring your feet closer to your butt, and you can also widen them to shorten that range of motion. Don't go to that point until you've gotten to a point where you can no longer reach your heels with your heels in a further position and closer together. Once it starts getting too difficult to where you can't get three or four in a row, then you can go ahead, bring your heels back towards your butt and lessen that range of motion. I want you to try for as long as you can to keep your heels together and further away from your body, just to give your body a little bit more of a challenge. Then once it starts getting a little too difficult, then we bring it in. And you can do that for each round. So each round, try to start in the same area, and then as the rounds go on, you might get more fatigued and might have to start scaling back a little sooner. Then we're gonna finish with split squat on the right leg. So same thing as the other split squat, it's just now it's gonna be on the opposite leg. And again, you can drop down to that glute bridge if you need to do that as well. All right. Normally I'd ask if you have any questions, but since you can't respond to me, I can't ask you. So, if you need a bathroom break or you need to go get some water before you start this, maybe a towel to wipe your sweat, go ahead and pause the video. Go do that real quick and then come right back here and we'll get started. If you haven't grabbed your family, grabbed your kids yet, grab them, bring them down, or wherever you are in your basement, garage, outside, in your living room, in your kitchen, wherever you're doing this, bring them in, let's get started. All right, so again, it's 30 seconds of work, 30 seconds of rest for four rounds, alternating V-ups, split squat on the left, the heel touches, split squat on the right. I'll help guide you through it. Have a good time. Just enjoy moving. If you need to challenge yourself more, throw in that Bulgarian split squat with the leg up. Biggest thing, just keep moving throughout the whole 30 seconds and have a good time. If you hear some good music coming through and you want to dance, dance. Enjoy it. If you enjoy the process, you're going to want to do it more. So if you see some of us dancing, smile, dance along with us. We're just having a good time. You guys ready? Air Nucks and Shakas, have fun, have a good workout. 10 seconds. Thank you. base. We're not gonna be in a line like we're on a balance beam. A little bit of a distance if you wanna put your foot up on chair, couch, table, totally fine. Just be careful, make sure it's stable. Going in 3, 2, 1, go. Those felt too easy. Next round, throw your foot up on an object and try the split squat with an elevated foot. Next, we got the heel touches. In 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. On the right leg. If you felt like that first round was too easy on the left leg, don't put that right leg up quite yet. Let's do the same difficulty for this round, and then the next three rounds you can change it up. 3, 2, 1, go. This round, I'm gonna try to go through all the different modifications and scaling options that you can use. So make sure you kind of keep your eyes up at the video just to see the different options you have. We're going in 3, 2, 1. Remember, start your feet as close together as possible and as far away from your butt as possible that you're able to touch. Then once you start fatiguing, start bringing it back. Three, two, one. Workout. Biggest thing is that you just keep moving during that work time of 30 seconds. We're gonna go through each option again. 3, 2, 1, go! Awesome job. Keep up the great work. If you need to take a drink, take a drink. If you need to take a little bit longer break, all totally up to you. We got 10 seconds before we start the V-ups. 3, 2, 1. With the song. squat on the right. I know these are getting tough, these V-ups, but you only have 30 seconds left. Try your best to breathe through it and just keep pushing through for that full 30 seconds. In 3, 2, 1. Way to push through that. Now we've got split squats on the left side. Ten more seconds. Got heel touches in 15 seconds. These two ladies are going to show the harder version, and I'm going to show the floor version as well as the glute bridge. 3, 2, 1, last movement. Awesome job. You guys did awesome. I know those core got pretty tough, but you guys did a great job pushing through that. If you want to do a little extra work, you can always throw some of these core exercises in just randomly throughout the day, throughout the week. You can replay this video again if you want to go through this again. You can also, if you're starting this in the morning, you can turn around and do it in the afternoon. Do it twice. Whatever you want to do, just try to stay fit, try to stay active. It's great for your health, but it's also great for your family, your friends, and the health of everybody else around you. Please make sure you still try to move. And another thing, check in on your family, on your friends. I know where a lot of us are doing the social distancing, and some people are shelter in place. So you're not getting that face-to-face contact like you might normally get to do. So please just make sure you check in on everyone you care about and everybody that you love, just to make sure that they're doing okay, especially older people like grandparents. Make sure they're doing okay. If you're able to go out and about and get some groceries or anything they might need, please offer yourself up for them. They're the most susceptible, and it'll be easier for you to go out and about than them. Just make sure you take every precautionary step possible to make sure that you're safe and clean when you're going out to get stuff for them and bring it to their home. Also, check on any small business owners that you know. See how they're doing through this difficult time. I know it's affecting a lot of small business owners in a very big way. Small business owners, that's what they have. That's their life. They put everything they have into their business, and if they're not able to operate or they get closed down, they're not able to get money in the door. And that money is not just what a lot of people think it is for business owners. Like, business owners are rolling in dough, especially small business owners. That money that goes to all the supplies, all the rent just for their business, but then also that money has to be able to pay their employees, put a roof over their own head, put food on their table. If they have families, that's extra people that they have to provide food for. So please check in on them, see if there's anything you can do to help them. If they're still open in some way, shape, or form, try to support them, shop small. Just reach out to people. But if you have any questions, feel free to reach out. Facebook, Instagram, email. Please spread these videos as far as you can. If you have relatives or friends in another state, another country, feel free to send this out to them. It'll be on YouTube. You can copy and paste the link and an email. It'll also be on Facebook, the link will be. But please share it with everybody. We want to try to keep as many people as possible safe and healthy. So hope you have a great workout. Let us know what you think. Have a great day.